Everybody, welcome back. Falcon, Massive Chalice. If you haven't watched the first episode, I would actually encourage you to do so just because that actually describes and introduces the game itself as to what the hell we're doing, what's it about. It also teaches you about the battle system and also about the lineage system and regents and actually bearing kids that will continue the battle as we go along because this is a game that spans over years, centuries maybe, perhaps, but it spans over a long time, so it's really interesting in that aspect. So if you haven't seen that, if you are not aware of what I'm talking about, go check out episode number one before you check this out so you kind of have a feel for what's going on. Either way, right now we have to return to the capital because I ended the last episode talking about researching aspects of the game, which we will check out right now. So let's go in here and take a look at this.
And welcome back.
You are here, right? It's a little hard to tell if you're still in your mind's eye or whatever.
This is where your heroes return to after battle. From here, you may equip them with any skills or weapons they may have earned, as well as perform research.
Basically, we can devote some of our power to help the war effort and the nation. Whether it's building new keeps, starting a Sage Rites Guild, or a Standards Crucible. Fun stuff.
Alright, so that's a little bit of introduction right there as to what goes on in the quote-unquote keep. So let's check out the heroes number one. This will tell you everybody that you have involved at the moment. If you go to Regency, it'll tell you which of your soldiers are now regents. Again, you can't use your, you know, kings and queens, let's just call them that, as fighters anymore. The moment you put them into a keep to bear kids, that's it. No more battling for them. Standards is, we have not promoted any heroes into a crucible. Promote a standard in order to accelerate the experience gain of heroes in training. Sage Rites, we have not inducted any heroes into the Sage Rites Guild. Appoint Sage Rites in order to accelerate our research. Trainees, there are no future heroes in training. Appoint regents and partners to bear children to continue our bloodlines. And then disease, we haven't lost anybody just yet, so, you know, knock on wood, thankfully. For that, I mean, if I lost somebody in the first mission, then goddammit, just quit the game already, Falcon. So, these are our active people over here. I just wanted to show that off. Now let's go into research.
Building more keeps is likely the most pressing option, as you'll be able to foster more bloodlines. But don't shun the other possibilities. With your approval, we can research weapons, potions, armor. If the amount of time required dissuades you from researching something, consider the Sage Rites Guild. Any hero who joins the Sage Rites will hasten the time required for any pursuit. They will never see combat again.
Keep in mind, most of our power is focused on charging up to cleanse the Cadence, so we can only devote enough energy to research one thing at a time. That includes searching for new heroes. It takes a lot of effort to find people attuned with us, and it'll only get harder the more we do it. But choose whatever you want.
Oh, it'll get harder, all right. Either way, so, again, we can build another keep to actually assign another possible king or queen. Before the keep is actually built, we have to wait 7 years. So this is what I talked about, the whole aspect of the game taking place over, you know, centuries, if anything, because it's not hours and days like, you know, something like XCOM. It's fucking years that we're talking about here. So it would take 7 years to build the keep. This is actually a fast research, even though it's a fast research, even though it's only 7 years, which seems like a lot of time. They'd also build a Sage Rites Guild and build a Crucible. What I did the first time around, like, mind you, I haven't played this too much, but I took it for a test run before I started filming this. And I went with the Sage Rites Guild just because I like the idea of researching things faster than usual. Mind you, it's gonna, at the time, put us a little bit of a disadvantage because we won't have any good real research happening at the moment, but we're kind of building for the future in a sense. So I will be going with the Sage Rites Guild again. So the interesting thing about also building keeps and buildings in certain areas of this map here is that some of them are actually provide you boost to your armies and different type of boost in general depending on where you build certain items. So let me see with the Sage Rites Guild we could actually make this happen. So for instance, this is an empty region. I'm trying to find somewhere where, oh, here we go. So construct a building in this region to promote this bonus. So if I build something over here, all of our hunters will get a dexterity boost. A dexterity boost. I meant boost, obviously, but a boost wouldn't be that bad either, depending on what it is. Up here we have all heroes cadence kill experience bonus. That's actually pretty good. And then what do we have here? Construct a building in this region. This is nothing. And what about here? Oh, Caberjacks will get a strength boost. So you know what? I like the experience one. Not gonna lie to you. So let's do all heroes, cadence kill, experience boost. So we'll build this over here. Alrighty.
Yeah, one more thing. The end of this war is not even a glimpse on our horizon yet. But your immortality gives us an advantage. The ability to step back and let time pass.
You can start and stop this timeline at will. But we'll also stop it for you should something require your attention.
Like a cadence attack.
That is a probable possibility.
Alrighty, so I do apologize for this episode so far and the first one being a little bit more slower paced, more tutorialized on my part. I try not to make most of my Let's Plays like that, but I do also want to install most of the information that I'm already aware of to you for any new people that are considering getting the game or just want to learn about it in general. That's the reason why I'm not kind of freestyling and bebopping, if you know what I'm saying, dog. I'm not freestyle or free flowing through the game. I'm trying to take step by step, so, and letting the NPCs talk to us so that, you know, anybody that wants to just learn about it can get that. But beyond this point, I think it kind of gives this free rein, so then we're kind of, you know, let the horses loose, essentially, or let the horses loose? Isn't it let the dogs loose? Whatever. We can continue going forward now. So at this point, it's up to us. Everything's been given to us at this point, and now we're just going to start going forward here. And again, this is going to take place in years, so expect, you know, time to fly by. So in the process, this kind of works a little bit like XCOM when you're kind of flowing through the earth and waiting for alien attacks. And the game will stop itself whenever something arises. Sometimes there's story events, random events, and things of that nature.
A cause for celebration indeed.
Babies have been born before today.
And it was glorious every time, was it not?
What, unbearable shrieking and smells that are even worse? That's your idea of glorious.
Yes.
I'm gonna tell you, that lady has the right idea. Fuck that, man. Not a big fan of babies, personally. Maybe. I could say most people say that, right, until they actually have their own kid and it's kind of like, you know, the best thing in their life that's ever happened. Maybe I'm the same way, who knows? Either way, babies, heroic children known as trainees, that's a way to put it, are bound to the keep they are birthed in. They are trained by the regent and partner in that keep until they are 15, at which point they are transferred to the capital for active duty. So, obviously, Domingo Torres and our queen, was it Cassandra Carlson? I forgot what her name was. But either way, they've been busy. And they gave us a kid in 2 years and 118 days. So it took them a little while to actually start getting a little bit raunchy, if you catch my drift here. But they did give us a kid. So for now, they're going to hang out at their regent or at the keep itself. And once they're 15, they will be transferred to our keep in order to join the active roster here. So that's cool. Let's continue going forward here and see what else happens. And over here is going to tell you the upcoming events. So our Sage Rite is going to be built in, you know, under 6 years at this point. And then we have this, which is Chalice Fully Charged.
On the battlefield. Now, we'll be making choices on the battlefield of life. What?
Come on.
I will not apologize if I'm passionate about...
You know when you guide the heroes in battle? Well, sometimes the people, your heroes included, will want your advice on matters they can't decide themselves.
They'll be putting their choices in your hands, and sometimes their lives.
And the decisions you make may affect the morale of the nation.
Unfortunately, we've learned that the Cadence feeds off grief and malcontent. So if something tragic happens, corruption can spread very quickly.
But the opposite is true, too.
We will trust your decisions, whatever they end up being.
Alright guys, welcome to Massive Chalice Plays Massive Chalice. Alright, are you done, game? Can I finally take over the fucking game now? This fucking Massive Chalice, you know, has got a massive attitude, let me tell you that much, always cutting me off. Either way, field trip. A teacher would like to bring... This is a random event that I talked about earlier on. This is going to happen on occasion, and based on your decisions, it will have an effect on your... I guess overall game, there's going to be sometimes positive effects from decisions, sometimes negative effects, but again, it's a really interesting random event aspect that I really enjoy because it kind of adds a little bit more of, I guess, like more variety in terms of the gameplay and things that you can actually experience with, you know, each other run. Field trip. A teacher would like to bring her class to the capital so they learn about how the nation is governed. However, she didn't want to wait for a decision, and now she and her students are standing before you with the most pleading eyes you've ever seen. What do you say? Of course, but please stay in the throne room. Try the barracks, our heroes are far more interesting hosts than I am, and go over where you'd like, whatever helps with your education. So, I'm gonna be a king that justifies learning and education so that maybe we'll have some smart people down the line. So let me go with, yeah, go wherever you want to go. A day to remember, the students spend all day exploring the nooks and crannies of the capital, with a few kids even getting lost in the black archives for half an hour before someone caught them. And are so tired by the end of the day, actually pay attention to you talking on managing expectations. They even have questions. When it's all over, they file out of the throne room and you hope that today was enjoyable for them as it was for you. Alright, so apparently I'm a kind-hearted guy in real life. Or in game. Not in real life, I'm kind of a grumpy dickbag. That's not true. Well, we had another kid, though. Hey. Alright, Domingo Torres, you need to, you know, relax here, my friend. You're having kids constantly now. You're like a baby machine. So we have another baby boy. This is going to be Koskrob. Has been born to Domingo and Kalindra at Thor Munulsa. So we have Koskrob. And we also have a baby boy at this. Alrighty. Now, if I click on them, it's going to actually take me to them. So this will tell you, you could, you know, stop meanwhile and go into each kid and see what kind of traits they have. So Atthis Taurus has strength. Unfortunately, the sickly trait is not something I'm too crazy about. No personality just yet because obviously they were just born in young age already. So let me get back out here. Let me check on this dude. Strong-willed and tranquil. Increased accuracy. Nice. You could be probably a good hunter. So obviously you're not gonna always get the same exact traits with each kid. It's gonna be really, I guess, encouraged by depending on who the father and mother are. But there's also gonna occasionally be a little bit of a random chance thrown in there as well, so keep that in mind. But it's gonna be mostly based on the father and mother, but keep in mind that there's also like the chance of a random type of trait sleeping in through there. Let's continue going forward a bit more then. Our shipwright's almost just about done. We have a territory attack before then.
As you have no doubt surmised by now, it takes time for the Cadence to create its pawns, so they're only able to attack every few years. Unfortunately, you cannot fight back multiple incursions at the same time. Our primary focus is charging up to destroy our enemy, and we can only allot enough of our energy to send out one group of heroes at a time.
Pawns don't last long outside of the Cadence either. So even if you win one battle, it'll be too late to fight the other.
Choose wisely and
blow the horns! Yeah!
Alrighty, so now, as they pretty much explained to you, there's actually an attack now from the Cadence, which, you know, takes place every few years. And again, it'll give you a choice of two different areas you could kind of go and attack or defend. Mind you can't do all both of them, so you have to kind of pick and choose which one's a little bit more important to you. Obviously, I'm going to go with this one because that is where our Sage Rite is being built right now, so I don't necessarily want to lose that area. So it's going to be reward. It's going to be 2x experience for each enemy killed. And then over here, we have a young level 1 male alchemist. So pick and choose. Do we want a level 1 male alchemist? Or do we want the 2x experience for each enemy killed? Over here, we're going to be dealing with seeds, ruptures, and lapses. And over here, we'd be dealing with seeds and lapses. The ruptures are the dudes that I talked about in episode 1 who actually blow up and cause damage after they do so, which is a little bit more difficult to kind of maneuver. But because of the experience boost, and that's the area that I'm kind of building the Sage Rite, I have no choice but to go there, so we will. So let's check this one out. That is going to be our next area. And over here, we're going to be able to choose our party for this endeavor.
You feel it? That little tingling in the air before
Yeah, I feel it. All right, you know what I feel? I feel like you've talked enough already, and it's my turn.
Substitutions or preparations before you deploy your heroes to battle. Once you give the word, they'll jump in, and we'll handle the rest.
Make sure they close their mouths when they jump.
Yeah, maybe you should take your own advice. Maybe you should close your mouth for once. How about that? Alrighty, so over here we have Hunter, Caberjack, Hunter, Caberjack, and Hunter. I like my hunters, I really do. But I would like to also grab a alchemist for this battle just to show off their skills as well. So let me go with 2 hunters, 2 Caberjacks, and 1 alchemist. So let's see here. Not too crazy about that unable to have children thing. So let's go with Stephen Lee instead. Alrighty, and we're good to go. Let's deploy. Jump in there. And apparently you gotta close your mouth before you jump in there. Maybe the game will do the same for us.
We don't want to keep the Cadence waiting.
Alright, so this is new. I've never actually have gone into a map where the Cadence are like, boom, right there in front of me. Usually you kind of have to roam around the fog of war aspect and find them in that regard. But hey, hopefully it makes it a little bit easier for us, right? So we have a rupture. This is a dude that I talked about. After killing him, he will explode, and he actually has a very, a little bit insensitive for me to say it this way, but he has a little bit of a, you know, Taliban bomber type of mentality where he's going to rush you and just blow himself up and cause a lot of damage to you and actually do a little bit of an area of effect attack following that up. So here we go. We want to make sure we kill this guy from afar and fast. So we have Mirren Ol. Mirren Ol has a 75% chance to hit, 9 of 12. Okay. And then we have Percival Melraki. What about you? You have 85% chance for 13 to 17 damage. Let's go ahead and take this one first. Get one of the enemies out of the way first and foremost. That'll help us out quite a bit. Ken Carlson, you can come over here and get an attack on. So how about you hopefully finish this person off? Excellent. Push me back. Oh, we actually got a little bit of damage right there. Oh no! It stunned my crossbow person too. Shit.
I admire the ruptures.
What?
They rush into battle.
I'm not too happy about that. We just basically just lost the turn with the sniper, which I was going to use to actually get a kill on this seed over here. So now we have to try to kill this rupture in two attacks. I don't see it happening, but we'll see. Crossbowman, 11 of 14 damage if you hit. Let's see, you also have the follow-up. Standard attack that fires a second shot for 50% damage if the first shot hits. If we actually land this, we could kill this rupture in one go, so let me try it out. Did we not do the follow-up thing? Or, oh, I didn't confirm it. My bad. I right-clicked instead of left-clicking on this skill. Alrighty, well, there you go. Don't do that. So over here with the alchemists, what's cool about them, they actually have a chance to throw flask. Obviously, this is kind of like a limited skill. They only have 5 uses of this. You could actually do melee attacks with them, but their prime example or their prime skill is to be able to throw stuff from far off. So if we want to kill this guy without causing that whole area of effect thing, it's probably better that we throw this flask. Mind you, it's not really accurate. So we could do 60% chance to kill, or we could just go in there for a melee attack. 70% chance to hit. It's not really that big of a difference, so you know what? I'm gonna actually go with the don't confirm that. I'm gonna go with the throw flask here. Alright, hopefully it hits. I really hope it does. If it doesn't, we're kind of a little bit fucked right now. So let's confirm it. Fuck. You weren't even fucking close. Alrighty, and that's our turn. So now, this is where the fireworks happen, because we passed up an opportunity to kill this rupture. So he's gonna go over here and just kamikaze himself on us. That's not good damage right there at all. It's actually pretty bad damage. Don't do it. There he goes. This is how we blow ourselves up. And there he goes. This is the area effect I talked about, which is gonna actually cause armor corrosion to our people. So I'm not happy about that, because this guy already has pretty low HP because of the seed attack. So, obviously it's not the end of the world, but it's something that I'd rather would have not dealt with here. Now then, these guys are still stunned, really? Are you kidding me right now? Alright, let's move Ken Carlson over here. I just want to keep an eye on this dude. Alrighty. And I just wanted to make sure where he was at. Let me move you over here for now. I don't necessarily want that guy coming over here and blowing himself up on you. Now what we want to do is actually get out of this area of effect and then get a shot over here. So let me move Atlas Blackstone out of here and then we'll take our shot. 55% chance to hit, not really great, but enough for the kill, and luckily we did hit. Alrighty. Now, Stephen Lee, you need to get out of here, my friend. You definitely need to get the fuck out of here. So let's move you over here for now just to get you out of that effect, and that's about it. That's our turn because the two of our people are still stunned. Here comes this guy. Luckily, he's not going to be able to get too far in, so everybody's no longer stunned. Excellent. So my plan would be to get this guy from far off, but this could possibly kill him in one go, but he's going to blow up right afterward, though. Let's see. Can a sniper possibly...
Found one of our alchemists.
Oh, you're going to start talking about the alchemist now. Dude, come on. He's not Edward Emmerich or whatever his name is from Fullmetal Alchemist, right?
For it with their nasty exploding flasks.
Alright, so I can't get the kill with the hunter in one hit, even if it did land it. So, let's move this hunter over here. Maybe you have a shot, I doubt it, but no shot. Alright, keep that in mind. Stephen Lee, can I move you over here and toss a flask all the way over there? No. Not quite. Alrighty, so unfortunately, that's not going to work out for us, so you just hang out here for a second while I kind of peruse my idea of what to do here. I guess we're going to have to send Kent Carlson in there and get an attack in. Luckily, Kent Carlson does have 18 HP, so he should be able to sustain the attack anyway, so let's go for it. Wow, he missed. So the glancing blows are when they actually miss, and don't necessarily get the full damage here. Now we have a lapse on us as well, so I'm not too happy about this overall exchange, honestly. Percival Melraki? Alright, it's up to you now, my friend, because that lapse is actually going to drain some experience. Alrighty. Good. Good, good, good. Oh, cool. Yeah, sure. Hey, everybody, I'm over here. Just an FYI. You just want to come check it out. Alrighty, so, Crossbow Man, this is up to you. You need to get this kill, definitely. Thank you. Mind you, we're still going to get the area of effect attack and the explosion damage, so you definitely want to knock them away when you kill them, otherwise shit like that's going to happen. Stephen Lee, you need to stay behind protection, my friend, because right now you are in really dangerous ground with 4 HP. And Artless Blackstone, you move over here and possibly get some follow-up shots next turn here. So the lab's going to probably do a long-range attack and hopefully not drain too much of an experience, but, you know, wishful thinking on my part. 150 experience loss, not too crazy about that, and we're still in the area of effect here, so we're taking corrosion damage. Alrighty, that's it. So, before we get too crazy with my caberjacks, let's see about getting some shots in with our snipers. So, Crossbow Man, let's run over here. Take a shot over here. 10 damage, good. That'll do. Let's see, you hang out here for a bit longer, Stephen Lee, and we'll have Atlas Blackstone come over here and possibly, hopefully, get the kill if it lands. Yeah, well, why would you land? I just needed it to happen. RNGesus, man. Alright, Percival Meraki, let's go in here and... Well, let me go in here and do the knockback. Low damage. No, we need to kill. We definitely need to kill. Charge? Well, we could do this one. Charge in a straight line for extra distance or to knock back a target. 4 to 5 damage, though. Again, not really great. Alrighty, let's hope that he doesn't blow up and hurt us in return. It's a possibility, but let's hope that's not the case. Alrighty, that's gonna be the kill. He pushed me back, but thankfully we didn't lose any damage, or we didn't lose any health. So remember, there's another seed over here, so that seed's gonna probably pop up really soon. Ken Carlson, you're gonna run and gun over here for now. And I think the seed's right about there, I just saw it right now. And then Stephen Lee, let's just move you behind this pillar and try to have some flaster when we get the chance here. That's gonna be our turn for now, and the seeds didn't do anything, so it's now continuing on my part. So Ken Carlson, let's move you over here. The seed is right there, so I'm gonna move Atlas over here and then get the shot off. Oh, if that landed, that could have been the kill right there, so unfortunately, it's not to be. Percival Meraki, you don't have a shot. Let's see, Stephen Lee, even worse. So how about we move you here? Oh, that's outside of the range zone. My bad, dog. Stephen Lee, let's move you over here for now, and I doubt I'll get a flask over there. Yeah. No surprise there. So for now, just move behind this pillar and just hang out. Take it easy for now. And I can't get a hit over here either. So I'm thinking we just kind of move forward a little bit. Expose some more of this area. No enemies in this range. So this guy's going to probably come after me over here, which is fine if he does. That's probably the best course of action I would expect from this turn of events right now. Oh! Went after my hunter. That's okay, too. You know why? Because I don't really put my hunters in much front damage anyway, so I doubt it's going to be too much of an issue. So I'm going to have him... I'm going to have Ken Carlson get this kill, hopefully. Boom. 120 experience. Let the ravens feast. Alright. Atlas Blackstone. You are my hunter. With only 5 HP, so I got to really move you carefully right now. And then we have Murin Ol. You're level 1. You have 7 HP still, so let's not get too crazy, but I could afford to move you a bit forward. You do have the stealth ability, so I should be using this a little bit more often. Sneak to a tall environment objects to blend in and hide from enemies. Let's actually use this. Actually, you have to use that next to a tall environment. Gotcha. Alrighty, so Percival, let me peek over here. Nothing happening. Alright. So let's just move you over here. Still nothing. Okay. How many more moves do I have left? A few. However, the moves that I do have left are people with a little bit low HP right now, so I can't necessarily put him in too much danger. So let me just move you here. Slowly but surely. Don't call me Shirley. Alrighty, two seeds. That's not the biggest problem imaginable. Now, if they both come over here and get attacks off on me, that could be a problem. I would expect this guy to maybe get an attack in, but not that guy. If it's two of them, then we're kind of in a tough spot, though. Stephen Lee, let's have you just post up over here. I'll try to throw some flask with him next time around if we get the chance. And then you are going to just push forward over here. That's going to be our turn. Now, let's hope that this guy... Good. Not enough to actually get a hit in. Alright, it actually works out for us pretty well. So, what I want to do is Stephen Lee, let's move you over here. You should... Oh, this is perfect. This could work out. Now, if I land this flask where it should land, I should be able to hit this guy and this guy. So, come on, man. Stephen Lee, this is your chance to shine. Alright, you at least killed one, so I won't necessarily be upset about that, but you could have gotten both of them at once, so, you know, make things a little bit easier on myself and actually get an extra move with this guy. But that's alright. That's alright. One was enough. Now, Ken Carlson, let's move you... Let's say up to here? Let's move you up to here first and see if we reveal anybody. Not yet, huh? Still quite a bit of ways of this map. We've been dealing with quite a few enemies right now, too. Okay, I saw another rupture right up here. Which I'm not too crazy about. So let's put you behind some cover for now. Oh, fuck. Where did you come from, you piece of shit? Alright, so he's gonna go after him, definitely, more than likely. But just in case he doesn't, let me put him over here so in case he comes around, he doesn't hit my hunter and he hits one of my caberjacks instead. Mirren Ol. Your HP is 7, huh? You could probably take a hit. Can you get a shot from this side, though? No, no. But you could use stealth now, right? You definitely can. Right? Tall environment, it said. Oh, here we go. Stealth. So let's see how this works. I'm still not too familiar with this mechanic, so we'll see how this works out for us. 4 HP, that's actually kind of a little bit too much. More than I really hoped for. Alrighty, so let's get the kill, first and foremost. Oh, really? You're gonna miss now. Come on, man. It's no time to miss. You're in a tough spot right now. Now, in terms of my stealth, dude, I wonder if the moment you leave this area, you unstealth up. If you do, then that's kind of shitty. But if you don't, I kind of like it. So let's move you here. Oh yeah, you come out of hiding. Oh fuck. And now that rupture's on my ass. Okay. We can't get a shot over here, so we'd have to... Here's the problem. This guy is going to be fucked next turn. Because he's going to take the explosion damage and he's going to take the corrosion damage. So we need to get rid of this guy this turn. I'm not sure if I'm capable of doing that either, though. Alright. It's going to have to be... You have to help us out, alright? So, you're not going to get enough damage. I mean, I'm not sure if you can even get a critical here. Caberjack. Alrighty, we need to get rid of this dude. So, let's have you come over here first. You got to be busting my balls so bad right now in order not to kill that guy. That's 2 misses already. Alrighty, where's Steven at? Fuck, all the way over here. Yeah, Steven's not going to be able to help us with the flask throw either at this point. So let's move you over here. Oh, god damn it, we're in such a bad spot. We need to get this kill, definitely. And this guy, well, I don't know, he's going to blow up on him easily. Alrighty, come on, man. You can't fucking miss this. You can't miss it. Oh. Well, obviously, you could miss it. I just was hoping you wouldn't. What are the chances I land? Oh, yeah, sure, I'll blow up my dude, too. Yeah, I don't think I want that happening. Fuck me. Alright. Alright. Can't get this hit on either. We have to go over here. I mean, he's not gonna do much. I mean, we're still in a fucked situation, but... oh boy, the C's gonna fuck everything up. Oh, okay, only 1 damage is actually pretty good, so he actually missed himself. Don't come after me. Oh! Base God? I'm not sure why he moved there, but thank God. You know what it could have been? He probably didn't see me over here. And instead of going after the hunter, he went over here. But that's fine. I mean, fuck it. I'll accept it. Just save my life here for a bit longer. So what we need to do is actually kill this guy from afar. No questions asked. But we also need to get rid of this guy once and are you fucking kidding me? What are you, like, the fucking most evasive man of all time? Jesus, alright. Fuck. Tripping out right now, man. I can't get this kill. Let's get rid of this man first. Alrighty, so, not a big deal if you blow up over there. Alrighty, Steven, what about you? Maybe Steven could fucking finish this off for us finally. Thank you, Steven. Get you a little bit of experience, too. And we still have more enemies about. Alrighty. So, Caber Jack, Ken Carlson, with your 10 HP. You're probably one of our healthiest dudes right now, so let's have you move up to here. Nothing sighted. Mirren Ol. Let's move you over here and see if you spot anything right now, my friend. You are not spotting anything. Alrighty. Let's move you. Let me just have you go back into stealth mode, perhaps. Stealth mode, I said. No stealth too. Oh, yeah, I guess it's not high enough. That would make sense. Alright. Let's move you a bit up to here. Still nothing. Okay, rupture over there. Now, we want to get eyes on him first and foremost, so let me use Kent Carlson to hopefully open up the way for us. Okay, there he is. Oh, fuck. I was not hoping for that, but it happened nonetheless. We're going to probably have you withdraw afterwards, but let me try to get a few hits off here if I can. No, it doesn't seem like I'm going to be able to. Not without risking this hunter. Let me try it out, though. That's not too bad. Good hit. And let's see. Steven. Maybe Steven could probably get a flask over there. Let me try it out from this angle. No. Okay. So what if we moved you... Trying to avoid the corrosion. Moved you here and then through this flask. Now, mind you, you have to land this. If you don't, then this guy's going to probably come over here and blow up on you. So let me leave that as a last resource type of effort here. For now, let me just move Atlas Blackstone over here. I don't think Atlas is going to have a shot. No. To be expected. No shot over here either. Let's get you behind this pillar. And you know what? I'm going to just have you move back. I don't feel comfortable taking that flash shot right now. And Percival, you're at 5 HP, so you're also kind of teetering along the lines of death here. So, maybe up to here? And can't charge, can't do a knockback, so... No, let me actually just move you back here. I feel like I went too far in. And this lap's going to come after you, so you know what? Let's give it a hard time at least. Let's move back, and let's just end it this way. Oh, you've... God, to be shitting me. So many enemies in this map. So another lapse, too. Rupture, don't play me dirty this way, dude. Alrighty, so now I could actually move back and take a shot off here. This would be for the kill. Boom. And that should keep us safe from damage as well. We got to level up with that archer, too, so that's pretty good. Alright, so we have a lapse somewhere over here, and then this rupture on this side. The rupture hasn't seen notices just yet, which is fine. How do I want to play this, though? 10 HP is actually pretty good. We could actually potentially get the kill over here if we land a hit. And we actually came close to it. Now, if I could get the archer to land his shot, I would take damage here for sure, but then we could actually rush the lapse afterwards and be done with it, so... No chance over here. Let me move you down up to here, and then we'll take the shot. Please fucking land this. Please land it. Thank God. Two damage is fine. That lap should not do more than 3 or 4 damage to this guy anyway. So we're fine in that regard. We definitely want to keep Stephen Lee behind cover because otherwise he's going to die. And then Percival. Let me move Percival over here. I hope that's not in the line of fire. And that's it. Let me end my turn. Got to keep an eye on his laps over here. This is the only problem that could worry us. 5 damage. That's actually more than I expected, but okay. Not the end of the world yet. That could have been right there. Okay, this would be close to the kill. Now, if we did this, let me move my archer over here. Oh, that was such a crucial fucking miss right now. That could have been the kill. Had we landed those 2 shots, that would have been over. Now, I don't think it's going to be over. I'm going to have to retreat that Caberjack. Unless Percival... No, it's not going to happen. Yeah, dude, you know, we just... that miss just basically changed the entire scheme of everything right now. Because now I have to definitely retreat over here. With 2 HP, I can't really risk it. And remember, he does almost 5 HP damage, we found out, so this is a one-hit kill, possibly. Oh boy. Let me move you over here, and maybe you can line up for a shot at some point. Not right now, but at some point. Let's move you behind a tree and just hang out here. Then Percival. Percival. 5 HP. If you have higher defense, you could probably, hopefully, bring the damage to 4, but what are the chances of that happening? Let's just move you over here for now. I don't like really bunching my people up. XCOM. Coming back to bite me in the ass when bunching people up, but luckily the laps missed, so we might be able to pull this through with my snipers at the very least. So let's move you here. Tell me you have a shot now. You do. Okay. And here we go. Let me just send the entire fucking casino at this man. Throw the house at him. Throw the barn at him. Whatever. We missed. Not great. Do you have a shot, Stephen Lee? Percival? Nope. We're back in square one. Hit and win. Hit and win. Oh, thank God. We took damage over there, but tell me that was the last enemy. Oh, my fucking lord.
Okay. Since you and your heroes did so well here, I'll try and make sure they're riding.
I'm not sure if we did well, but we got through it, and that's more than I could say at this point. That was a lot of fucking enemies in that map. Alright, so Stephen Lee got a level up. He got free throw now. With free throw, you could actually throw the flask anywhere, but it's going to be a quick flask throw that doesn't cost an action point. Oh, it doesn't cost an action point. That's how it works. Alright, never mind then. So we got that unlocked. Perfect. Mirror and Ol, you're going to get follow up, and then you could go down either one of these paths. So we're going to go to follow up, and boom, proceed. Massive victory for a massive chalice. Alrighty, so we are going to call it an episode here, I'm going to say. And hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Tougher battle in the first one already, so oof, gotta really start getting my game up for this one. And we have some kids that we're gonna have to take a look at, some babies that have been kind of growing up. This guy was born a while back already, so he's gonna probably be close to being part of our ranks kind of soon, so we have to see what the king and queen gave for us. But hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, I encourage you to leave a thumbs up, leave a like, the support does mean a lot. Other than that, I will catch you next time.